Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see different motor specification. Now we have learned what type of motors are available with us, how the motors can be chosen for different kinds of applications, what are the characteristics of a motors, and how different types of motor will give you the different types of characteristics. That we have already learned. But after learning these aspects of a motors, now when it actually comes to the selection of a motor or using the motor for a specific application and designing a different types of motor, you should be aware of some different specification which need to be considered before designing or selecting the motor. So we are going to see which are these different parameters in today's video. So there are some factors to be considered while selecting a drive motor. So first is the electrical aspects, second mechanical aspects, and economical aspects. So these are the key aspects, and we have a different parameters in all these three aspects which need to be considered. We will see one by one. These are some electrical aspects need to be considered before going for the selection of the motor. So first one is the supply. Now, what kind of supply is required for your motor, whether it is in the form of a DC or it is in the form of a AC. If it is a DC supply you are using, it is called as a DC motor. And if it is a AC, it can be categorized into either single phase or three phase. If it is a small kind of application, small term application, then you can go for a single phase. But if it is a application which should be run on the more power ratings or the high power, then you should go for a three phase. So depending on whether DC or AC or one phase or three phase, the supply will be decided first to choose that particular drive. Second, starting characteristics. Now whenever there is a starting of a motor, there are some motors those can directly connect to the actual supply, or the input supply is provided, and as soon as you apply the input supply, your motor will start rotating or your motor will start operating. But there are some kind of motors which cannot directly connect to the input supply or the input voltage. They need to have some bridge between. So that starting controlling device should be present. So which kind of device should be used? So that is nothing but the starting characteristic, whether it is directly starting or you need to have some bridge between the input supply and your motor to start the motor to be in an operating mode. Then you have a running characteristics. Now when motors start running, it will be decided by the everything, that every characteristics and its mechanism is completely depending on its speed. So whenever it is in a running condition, there can be some different types of load can get connected to your motor. So it is possible that it is running on a constant speed, but if you connect some kind of load at the output side, your speed can be increased or decreased. In most of the cases, the speed when load is connected will get decreased. So you have to maintain the particular speed at some constant value, then you need to take care that what kind of load you are connecting. And if you are connecting some kind of load, the value or the speed which is getting reduced, at what certain value it will be tolerable for that particular device. So this will define the running application or running characteristics of the motor. Second, we have a speed control. Sometimes you need to control the speed. At one instant you need to have a larger speed, and the second instant you need to have the smaller speed or the lesser speed. So that means after duration of a time you need to increase the speed or the decrease the speed. So that is called as a speed control. So speed controlling mechanism should be present in your device of that particular motor. So that is how the speed control should be known. So if the controlling is required, then you should be ready with the device which will going to control the speed of the motor automatically. Then you have a electrical braking. The electrical braking, that means if you want to shut down the device, if you want to shut down the rotation, how you are going to stop the rotation of the motor? If motor is rotating at the higher speed, how this braking will take place? This shutting down of the motor will be immediately or it will take some time. That will be decided, that characteristics will be given as a electrical braking. How, in which manner you are going to brake the speed of the motor. Power factor. Now the motor you are using, that how much power is required that motor to run at a higher speed or at its maximum speed. So power rating should be known before you select a motor. It should work and the high power factor and less power consumption should be present for that particular motor. So in that case, the power consumption will be less, but the power factor will be more. Seventh one is the efficiency. Now, each and every device when we use, we always need to have the maximum efficiency. Maximum efficiency is always 100%, but at least to obtain the good mechanism or to good performance, you need to have at least more than 75% efficiency. And efficiency is nothing but for the given supply, what is the output, what is the speed you are getting for the motor. So speed divided by the input supply will define the efficiency of the motor. So the given predetermined given input supply, your speed should be maximum. There should be no variation in a speed that will define the efficiency. Similarly, when there is a change in the input side, how the speed is changing according to the input given, that will also define the efficiency. If the device is efficient, it is more efficient, it will be always good to have that particular motor, which is a very much efficient as compared to other motors. Now, these are the electrical aspects which need to be considered whenever you go for the designing of the motor or selecting of the motor. Like we have some mechanical aspect also. So these are some mechanical aspects we have. Type of enclosure, type of bearing, noise level, vertical or horizontal drive, type of coupling used, individual drive or group drive. Now, type of enclosure. Sometime it is possible that only we have a two part for the motor. We have a stator, which is a stationary, and we have a rotor, which is a rotating part. Sometimes the enclosure use is the frame enclosure, and this frame enclosure is only given for the rotating part. That means for the machine, only rotating part will be enclosed. But there are some kind of motors which are used in an application like chemical industries or medical industries, where the whole part of machine, whole part of motor should be enclosed. It should not be visible or it should not be accessible with the human being for some damaging purpose. Because if that part is exposed to the human being or other parameters, there may be some chances of getting damages. So in such kind of application, the whole motor, that is the stator as well as the rotor part, should be enclosed in some kind of a enclosure. So that is the type of enclosure. What type of enclosure is required for the motor you are selecting or motor you are designing? Second is a type of bearing. Nowadays, for the high power application, we go for the ball bearing. So these are the different types of bearing is used in motor. For example, if there is a vehicle like a car or a bike, there is a bearing is used. That is basically to decrease the noise level or to decrease the friction which is happening due to the rotation of the motor. So that friction can be avoided or friction can be reduced to some extent, the noise which gets produced. For example, noise should be less if the motor is used in a medical appliances, in a hospitals, or you can say in a theaters. Whenever you use the motors in a such kind of application or such type of places, then there should be less noise which will be generated by the motor is required. So at this time, to control the noise level, bearing is a very important part. Vertical or horizontal drive. There are some kind of motors, they do not work in a horizontal manner, so they should be placed in a vertical manner only. Type of a coupling used. Now how the load can be coupled to the motor, that coupling is very important, because coupling losses should be as less as possible. Because whenever you couple some device with one device, coupling, that means you are joining two devices together. So if that joining is not proper, there should be some loss of a signal, there should be some loss of a power. So to avoid that, coupling is a very important. Individual drive or group drive. Individual drive is nothing but if your single phase is driving a single load, then it is called as an individual drive. But if single phase is driving a different or the many drivers, then it is called as a group drive. So these are the aspects which are related to the mechanical mechanism. So this need to be considered before going for deciding the mechanical characteristics of that particular motor. Then we have economical aspects, capital cost. Now, when your motor will be ready with the design, what should be the price of that particular motor? And price will be decided by what kind of components you have used and how efficient it is. If it is more efficient, the cost will be more. So this capital cost should be defined for that particular motor. Running charges. Now, running charges is nothing but if the motor is more efficient, then the demand for that particular motor will be more. If the demand will increase, also there will be increase or decrease in a charge. So there is always the ups and downs in a cost of the least efficient motor and the most efficient motor. So that is called as a running charges. Third is a maintenance charges. Now, once you have purchased the machine with particular one, a specific price, that is not enough that you have paid the price, you have purchased machine. Now this is at the end, but you have to maintain that machine throughout its life. You have to make some changes. You have to see what is the friction, whether it is damaging your motor or not. So maintenance is required, and maintenance, how much charge is required for the maintenance of that motor is also an important aspect. So that particular cost will get added into the actual price into motor. So this is what the economical aspects of the motor. So this three different types of aspects you need to take into consideration whenever you go for the designing of the motor or you are purchasing a motor. I hope you have understood what are the different aspects and how these different aspects are affect the designing of the motor or the purchasing of the motor. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to eKida. Do subscribe eKida. Thank you so much.